Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a Lego Creator set review. This is new for the winter of 2013 for the holiday season. It is set number 10235 and it's called the Winter Village Market. It has 1261 pieces and costs $99.99. $100 for 1261 pieces seems like a good deal based on price per part. Let's go ahead and check out the details of this amazing set with lots of pieces. I'm going to start with the minifigs. They give us 5 adults and 4 kids here, and they can all be kind of swapped around to represent different people doing different roles. So I'm just going to go through them and talk about what they look like briefly, because these are pretty regular folks. So this guy with Santa's beard right here, in one scenario on the box art, they show him operating one of the booths. In another, they show him being a customer. In another, it looks like he's just a grandpa out there. He actually has a young face underneath there. He's got this kid's face, actually, but doesn't really matter when you just have the beard covering it up. He's got the old-timer cap. It's like a police cap. Not really matching also well with the colors. No print on the back, but hey, you know, he's a guy. What do you expect? Next one up, this one I did go ahead and leave his implements in his hands from the suggestion of putting him in as the grill master behind the booth where regular food is sold. So this is supposed to be a chicken leg in this case. And he's got a hot link or sausage or something there. So he's got the kind of casual double shirt going on, and then a little something to keep his neck warm also. You can see the shape of that hat, and coming around to the back, nothing there for print once again. Okay, this lady is definitely well bundled up, keeping herself warm, got a scarf on there. Nice belt, I really like what they did with the belt. It's just nicely printed. She's got gloves on, obviously, with the white hands, and you can see a little bit of crow's feet in around her eyes to the edges. Got a little beauty mark there. And turn around to the other side. This one actually does have a print on the upper torso. And also there's a second face on this character. So she's got a not amused type of face on the back, or an annoyed face. So you can swap that around depending upon what she's doing at the time. And then here we've got just another lady, really mixing up the parts, using a different type of hair with the big wavy flap in the front and kind of balled up into a knot in the back. Sand green handbag going across the side. That's pretty nice. I like that piece. Yeah, it's a distinctive, recognizable color that we don't see used very frequently. And turning her around, no print there. And also on the face, only one of them. So not too many of these. Only 2 of these characters have double faces. I'll show you the other one, which is actually a kid, in a minute. And here's the final one, a lady who's got the old-time style of a shirt or a torso piece there, and no print on the sand green legs. Nice bright smile, nice dark brown hair color, and you can see the print on the back of the torso there. Got a little bit of gold color in there. Oh, there it is, that shine. Yeah, that's nice. Especially down here, you've got these little leaf or possibly flower or kind of like lotus designs down there. It's really, really fine, but so nice. So very nice. Okay, so that takes care of your adults. Now let's take a look at the kids. All right, 4 kids, and these are, again, just kind of mixed and not necessarily matched, but just put together. Kind of like the kids that I did recently, or not too long ago, for my own Lego layout. Just, you know, putting different stuff together, getting some different looks out of them. This gal over here has freckles on her face and really bright, wide eyes. You can see she's wearing gloves or mittens, I guess, also with a different color there, and probably a down jacket. There's something that's got a lot of fill in it. You can see it's really, really puffy. Turning that around, you can see there is print on the back here. All of these have print on the back of the torsos. And these are all proper kids in that they have all the short legs. So just going across all of them, you've got the short legs in red, normal blue, light bluish gray, and then this is a medium blue over here. Second kid over here, a boy, and he's got a hooded shirt on. I can see just a little bit of deviousness to his face. Like he's looking to cause some trouble, looking to get into trouble. Kind of reminds me, for folks who are fans of Ninjago, kind of reminds me of young Lloyd, you know? Just, you know, before he got brought in, he was still out there causing trouble all the time. It's kind of the vibe that I get from him. And then this kid has the reddish brown hair and matches his eyebrows also. Got a jacket on there, no gloves here. And also has a hood on the back of it, so if things get extra cold, maybe if the wind starts to blow, you know, put that over the top. There you go. And then the final one here is another girl, and she has just a very innocent face, you know, just kind of walking around, just enjoying life, just kind of absorbing everything. I think she's probably the youngest of the group here. And turning this one around, still a little bit of print here, but I saved this one for last because this one also has a second face. So you can turn that around and have the kind of either worried or sad kind of face there. So I'll just show you what that looks like from the front. Maybe something went wrong, or she wasn't able to get something she wanted, or dropped a piece of food that she had and now, you know, it has to be thrown away or something like that. So there you go. Those are the kids. You've seen the adults. Now let's start looking at these structures. I start with these because they're just so simple and we can just get them out of the way quickly. Basically, they're just some stand-up tables that you're supposed to walk up to, something you might see around some sort of fair, you know, just a quick place to set some food down. So if you're eating, you know, while you're out there, you have a place to put stuff. And this just shows you what the kind of the scale of a minifigure is. Three of those, and one of them has, looks like a cupcake or something like that. One of them has a drink. Of course, you can move stuff around, but you know, nothing too fancy or special about those. This is a little nicer. It's basically just a park bench, and you can see it's on a white base, so that's intended to mean snow, a snowy area. Got a little bit of an angle you can put on here, however you want that. And there's a cat on the bench. Of course, you can put that anywhere that you want in the entire layout. Just put it there. They kind of suggested it. And then the especially nice thing here is the street lamp, which, you know, it's a nice, cheery design. It's got a little wreath on the side for the holiday season. And you can see they use the two-piece globe design and just put a transparent yellow cylinder, one-by-one cylinder inside of there. The whole thing is built on a lance, a jousting lance. You can see the handle was right there, and it's actually just facing down going into this cone. And it looks nice. I like that use of parts. It just looks like proper glass with a, you know, with a colored light inside of it. This is kind of a confectionery booth, and you can see that you've got some dessert items out here and more of them here also. It's just a place to come and get some sweets. Nice little design on this, very, very compact. Nice colors. I like the dark red and the tan and the dark green. Those they look kind of classy, they look kind of classic, but I think they go with each other pretty well. This is interesting, this awning piece here. You can actually adjust the angle of that a little bit. You can see the lady who's in there right now. A little bit of a kind of wreath type of detail used here. Very steep edges to the roof there. And let's just look at how that goes together from the back. You can see the hinge pieces used here. Got some slopes used here. Got some arches used, and you see there's plenty of room to put the minifig in there. Might even be able to find a way to put two minifigures in there comfortably at opposite corners. You've got a space that's 6x3 in there, so you can actually put it, the minifig, halfway in without it being all the way at the back, without it being kind of shoved all the way up to the front. So I like that. You know, it's a good use of space, and you can see a couple little cheese wedges used around the edges to represent a little bit of snow piling up around the edges, and these also represent snow just slightly sticking to the sides of the roof. All right, let's move on. This booth focuses on bakery items. So the idea here is you got a cream pie and I guess a couple of cupcakes or something like that, and then a couple of croissants here. The lady has her pretzel, so that's why I put her here. But again, of course, feel free to swap people around. There isn't a right or a wrong on who you put where. I very much like what they did here on the front fascia. It's the brightest, most colorful, I think best looking of all of them that they did here, because they have the white and red alternating down here, and then just this design used in here. They actually brought in a little bit of bright green. These flower pieces behind these edges here are bright green, whereas the middle round plate is just a normal green, so that just livens it up even more. And still keeping with the general classy classic motif, you've got these pieces with the texture on the sides, and nice use of dark, again dark brown here, and then that's gold top and bottom. So just, you know, really it's nice. I like it. This is angled forward on a couple of hinges, so you can, it really presents the food items to you, as opposed to just doing it horizontally where it would, it's not actually going to fit with her in the space, but just not, you know, it's a little more cramped like that. This way really just puts it right out there. Easier to grab these things, swap them in with the hands of some of your minifigs, and even have a little bit of texture on the back here. Use gold pieces in there, so it still looks good from the back. And again, you've got a 3x6 space in there, so plenty of room to comfortably put your minifig right in the center. Very nice. Let's move on to the next. So this here is another food hut. And again, they've done some colorful stuff up front. Got the bright green used in here. Got the alternating trans orange and green pieces used up here. I guess they would represent lights that, I don't know, they might be flashing, you know, kind of sequentially or something like that. Got a surface on the top, a couple of glasses, and there's the grill master dude. But the grill itself is right here, and you can see that there's transparent orange pieces used underneath. Looks really good up against this side. This by itself, it's kind of obvious what they're trying to be, but when they actually have this kind of chimney element there and having a hood on the top, that really makes it work for me. I really like that. And even with that in there, you've still got enough space for the guy to sit in there and have a little bit of room for his arms and things in his hands. So again, good use of space. And another thing that looks pretty good from every angle. Of course, it looks best from the front, but still pretty good from all angles. You can see under the awning, alternating colors again here. Here we're using the gold and white. So it's just keeping it festive and lively, you know? All right, let's move on to the big thing. This obviously is the centerpiece of the set. You've got a carousel that is amazingly well adorned with all sorts of bright and shiny things and lots of colors and things that represent lights. You've got a booth that's attached to it. They've used two plates here, not base plates, but actual full height plates attached to the side, side by side, and then there's actually a little bit of an extension towards the back. But the great thing about this is that it actually works. It actually moves. Not only does the carousel go around, but the horses are going to rock back and forth. So you've got two horses on here. Let's just see how that works. You've got a crank over here. This is brilliant. It's so brilliant. And it's easy. It's really easy to make this turn. You can see how the horses are rocking back and forth. See, there's the devious kid. He's riding the horse backwards. Look at that. It's so nice, so simple. And there are a lot of really brilliant things that went into this design. So let me go ahead and just focus on the carousel itself first, and I'll show you some other stuff. So these pieces here, all of these round pieces, you can see they are actually mirrored. They have mirror chrome stickers on them. and as they go around. If your lighting is just right when you do this, where you've got light coming from the right angle, you'll actually see the light reflected from these onto the ground. It kind of has a little bit of a disco kind of effect, but it just brightens and livens up the whole scene even more. You've got two of these horses that rock back and forth, and look at them. These are not just plain horses. Look at that. Look at all of that gold, the inscription all over there, fine lines coming around the side. Both of them are the same, but that's just beautiful work. The eye looks nice. It's really good, and these newer horses have the nice tail. It's really shaped up really well. You've got little details on the mane also. The only difference between the two horses and how they're put together is that this one uses the little flame pieces in blue, and if I turn this around to the other side, the other one just has these red ones attached onto it. Also chrome-based or chrome-backed stickers used down here, just to add this little bit in here. The sleighs in between, little sleds, they're the ones that don't move, so that's for folks who are a little bit more afraid of motion, or for younger kids who really aren't cleared to use the full rocking horses in there. Look at all these lights back here. They represent lights, and it's just a whole lot of transparent pieces. It goes all the way up. They actually have arches used up underneath, so even as you look at this closer from underneath, if you ever get that view, get an extra treat of seeing those arches. Really nice. This is just a beautiful thing. And of course, you know, you've got all these details around the sides, and it just goes together really well. The top is these flaps. These are cloth, and they look nice. They've got an overlap. Got the blue going over the white. They're not too thin, so they kind of hold their shape, and they look nice and universal all the way around. Down at the base too, you've got a little bit of. You've got a small tree here, larger tree on this side. You've got stairs on three sides, so here, here, and then you can see them on the back also. Yeah, go ahead and turn it around, doesn't really matter. It still looks good from every angle. It's just a beautiful thing. It's so festive, and it's also kind of season independent, because, you know, you could imagine this not being in a snowy scene. It's still something you could use right in the middle of summer. So let's look at the booth over here, because they've got some real tricks up their sleeve here, what they've done with this, multi-purposing the Technic gearing. But first, the booth is intended to be an attraction of itself. And so these are intended to be kind of pucks or something that you would toss. You know, it's one of those kind of carnival booths where you have a game. And the intent here with the game is that you would, you know, buy the right to use a certain number of these, and then you try to toss them into little buckets back there. So you've got four buckets in there, and you try to get them in there. Can't really do it in this Lego scale, but, you know, do a little bit of imaginative play. But the great thing here is that those buckets actually go around, and that's done in conjunction with the crank that turns the carousel. So you'll see the carousel turning over on the left side, and you'll see the buckets going around in the middle. And the timing and the speed, it all just works out. It's just multiple purposes for, it's just one cohesive action altogether. And it's just geared, the main gear there is pretty obvious, but the smaller ones, little bevel gears down at the bottom, are a little bit more hidden. And if you win at that game, then you can get a teddy bear. So they include a teddy bear here. And they had this one in one of the collectible minifigure offerings. Here you've got another one of those street lamps. I think they suggest that you assemble them that way. I actually like them like this a little bit better, where it's open and clear more from the front, where you see it the most. A little more festive details used here. You've got a refuse bin here. Another small tree, which really, I mean, this corner would have been just fine without the tree. This is just an extra add-on thing, just making it even more complete and nice. And then from the back is where you can really see where the crank is. So the crank is on the top. Small gear here, large gear there. You just turn this and it's just, you can see I'm doing it with one finger. It's so, so easy. And then the top of this actually has a, this is hinged too. It doesn't really do much to do that. It might give you a little bit of better access to get the person in there. But again, there's plenty of space for your minifigure, so it all works out. These front lights are attached with black bracket pieces that are used for minifigures. So I'll just take one of those off so you can see exactly what it is in black. Don't see that in black very often. As a matter of fact, I think I've seen it in black before, but I don't know if I've ever had them. I've not done the research to see if that's a new color for that part, but you get four of them with this set. I feel like there was one other thing that I wanted to point out with this piece. Yes, I want to show, for folks who haven't seen the instructions, how the horses rock. So I'm gonna carefully try to pull up this entire center, if I can. There we go, okay. Just have to be a little bit careful putting that back together, but so the horses are on hinges, not hinges actually, they're on Technic long pins, the long Technic pins. You can just barely see inside of there. Actually, I'll give you a little view of it right there. It's that one. That's where the horse is actually hinging back and forth. It's one of those three long Technic pins, the longest ones, goes all the way through. It has no friction on it, and it just hinges right there. You've got a couple of these lift arms with a round edge that come down here. So anytime this hits something, that will cause the rocking action. And what it's actually riding over in this base here is a series of arches or curved top pieces. So that's just going around in circles, and every time it hits one of these, it will rock. It's there and it rocks, it's there and it rocks, and it just goes around. Everything is covered with tiles here, and then there in the middle you can see that bevel gear, which is one of the last gears in the system, which goes and attaches or mates with that right there, and that's what actually turns this whole thing. So the whole thing is just attached with a handful of small little studs, and I'll go ahead and put that back on. Get it lined up, push it straight down, and yep, looks like that's gonna work. There you go. So, you know, it shouldn't be too hard to make this motorized if you want. You know, have it actually be electrical. Your gear is exposed right there. You can even put the motor inside. Various things that you can do. But overall, just so much fun and so much nice design. Wow, there's just so much going on with this set. It blows my mind that they've given us all this functionality. So many different things, so many minifigs, you know, large pieces, you got the horses, decorated stuff, just really nice stuff, and a total of 1,261 pieces, and it's $100. I mean, that's just an incredible value. It's a steal. I don't know how they've managed to put it out for so cheap. So, nothing but good to say about this. This is, I mean, it's a really good set, but it's one of the best deals that we've seen from LEGO in sets in a long time, I think. Just really incredible there. So lots of fun. Love the minifigs. The fact that they're, you know, there isn't really a theme to the minifigs. You can just mix and match them however you want. They don't have uniforms. You can, you know, switch things back and forth. You can pretend that any one person is doing any type of thing. You know, they're not really kind of pigeonholed into certain roles and everything. So it's great as a collection together, but also plays well with other themes and other things. So just good all around. Really happy to have had a chance to check this out and to share it with all of you. That's it for this review. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to stay tuned for more reviews to come, as well as custom stuff. I'm kind of lagging behind in custom builds because there have been so many great sets to review, but I will try to fix that balance going forward, and I'll be bringing you more updates soon, so stay tuned to JANGBRiCKS.com and this YouTube channel. Bye for now.